Hi, I'm Cameron McKenzie at Cameron MCNZ on Twitter. And by the way, I was actually born in Ajax, Ontario. And I wanted to talk to you about Struts, Ajax, not the town, and jQuery. So starting off here, the first thing I need is a web project. So I'm going to create a Maven project in Eclipse. Just make it a simple web project. And I'm going to put in the basic attributes here. I'll make my group ID com.mcnz. My artifact ID will be struts ajax jQuery. And of course, this is going to be a WAR file because we've got a web application here. So I'll click finish on that. Now, as that kicks off, I'm going to copy and paste a whole set of dependencies from a POM file that I've got on a web page here in my GitHub repository. And these are all needed in order to get this Struts jQuery example to work. So here we are right in here. Don't worry about that red X there. Actually, it's a white X in a red background. That's just saying we need a web.xml file. I'll address that in just a moment. But I'm going to paste all of these dependencies in here. And so just watch this. As I said, you can get these from my GitHub repository. So the dependencies that I've got here, I'm just going to format this very, very quickly. Obviously, the Struts core. Struts convention gives me access to annotations. The Struts, the Java servlet API, obviously gives me access to all of the good things that come from the servlet API, like my session and my request and response objects. That's just a dependency. Now this here is the Apache Struts jQuery plugin. So this is the one that's going to make jQuery work and the jQuery custom tags work. There's a bunch of other dependencies that you can add from this project for data grids and trees and other GUI components, but I'm just going to use the core Struts jQuery library here. It's also worth pointing out that I've also got a build directive in here, and that build directive is going to ensure that I'm compiling against 1.8 binaries, even though locally I think I've actually got JDK 11 installed. So that's the Maven file right there. Now it is complaining that there's no web.xml file, and while I am a big advocate of zero configuration applications, we do need a web.xml file in this case. So I'm going to go to the web app folder, create a new folder called webinf, pronounced with all uppercase letters, and then I'm going to create a new file called web.xml, pronounced with all lowercase letters, and just put in the required struts mapping. And struts works with struts 2.5 with this struts filter. We don't have the controller anymore. We now have a filter, which I think is a much more sound design. And of course, with this URL pattern, it means everything that comes into this particular project named struts ajax jQuery is going to go through this filter. Now that's just the basic setup. It's now time to get into developing all of our web resources. So I'm going to create a new file right off the bat, and I'll call it ajax link. It'll be a new file, ajaxlink.jsp. It is a Java server page, and being a Java server page, we should put some page directives or tag lib directives at the top. I'll leave off the page directive for now if it doesn't complain, and it looks like it's not. But I do have these directives. That includes all the struts tags, and this is the jQuery struts tags, and you notice the SJ right there. Now, whenever you create a web page, you're supposed to, well, it should be well-formed, which means it starts off with HTML, and then you should have a head tag, and then stuff inside of the head tag, and then you've got a body tag as well. Now, one of the things you need to include if you are doing struts, if you are doing jQuery, using the jQuery struts plugin, you have to have the struts jQuery element head inside the head of this application. So that is an absolute requirement. Now I'm getting a little bit of feedback here. I think that's just because I haven't updated the Maven project. So make sure you do that. Update project, that will download all of the files that are associated with that pom.xml file, and I'm hoping that that little error message there that it can't find SJ head will go away. So let me do that little Maven update project, and then after that, see if I can do a run as Maven install. And I'm hoping after I do those couple of things, that error will go away. But it's not going to stop me from going forward. In the body here, what I need to do is I'm just going to create a basic struts link. So there's nothing crazy about this. This is just a regular struts link. It's not, doesn't have anything to do with the, it doesn't have anything to do with the struts jQuery APIs. All this does is creates a struts link. Its variable is Ajax link, that's what it's named. It calls on the hello action. And is it the hello action that I'm going to be doing? I think it's going to be the Ajax hello action that I'm going to be doing here. And it passes one parameter called handle, and it's just going to be my Twitter handle, at CameronMCNZ. And now we will have an Ajax link in the code. You'll notice right here, the next line is to take this URL, which was defined with this variable Ajax link. By the way, don't use ID there. If you use ID, you'll get a compile error. We no longer have ID in struts URLs since 2.3, I believe. Now here is the struts jQuery tag. And notice this struts jQuery tag, its ID is link one, that's fine. It is going to use the URL defined in this link created up here, right? So this URL is associated with this Ajax or this struts URL that was created earlier. And this is going to target the div named Ajax result. And so this just creates a link on the page that says, say hello to at CameronMCNZ. Now, what is this Ajax results here? Now that's going to be a div. So what you do is you create a div on the page. And so this div is named Ajax results, right? The target of the Ajax call is Ajax results. Initially, it's just going to say jQuery struts Ajax results goes here. So that's just going to be what displays initially so that, you know, the person using this application knows where the Ajax response is going to go. But what's going to happen when someone clicks on this link is this is going to get removed and new HTML is going to get put in there asynchronously. It's all going to happen on the same page. So that's the target of the Ajax call. Now that's really the whole kit and caboodle as far as struts and jQuery and Ajax development goes. But there are a couple of pieces of the puzzle that need to be added. We need to add this hello action, and we also need to create the page that is going to generate that results. So I'm going to create that action class. I'm going to come over to my Java resources here, create a new class in the com.mcnz.struts package. It's going to be called the Ajax hello action. And it's going to, well, it's going to have a couple of annotations on it. So it's an action class, so I need to put the action annotation on it. It's going to call, the action is named Ajax hello. Let's make sure it's the name that I use there. Yep, Ajax hello. And when this runs, if we get a success indication, we're going to send to the results.jsp file to generate that HTML fragment. Now, I haven't created that file yet, but I will in a moment. But first things first, I have to create the execute method, which is where the logic for the action goes. I can just say, hey, print out the handle, and then return the keyword success. Well, I guess it's not a keyword, but it's a string, right? If there's success, we will send somebody to this page. And so that return success causes that page to run. Of course, it's barking because it says handle. What the heck are you talking about with handle? And I'm like, well, handle is the property right here that is getting submitted to the server when someone clicks on the URL. And the struts action is saying, yeah, but you haven't defined that as a property. I'm like, oh yeah, I haven't done that yet. So now I have to say private string handle and add in the requisite setters and getters. So the setters and getters are now added. And so when this Ajax link is clicked, that Ajax link is clicked asynchronously, the value at CameronMCNZ is going to be passed as part of a name value pair where it says handle equals CameronMCNZ. And that word handle will end up getting mapped to this struts action class right there in that parameter handle through the setters and getters. And that's why I can then say handle right there. Now I am getting a little bit of clapback here. Notice result cannot be found and action cannot be found. That's because I have to organize my import. So source, organize imports. It's going to find that struts action right there and the result annotation as well. So I save that and those errors go away. And I'd have to say this is looking like a pretty handsome struts class. Now let me just make sure I haven't missed anything yet. Oh, I guess what I have missed is this results JSP. And so what's going to get shoved right in here when this runs? Well, I want to have a JSP that's going to say, hey, hello. So I'm going to create a new JSP. Results.jsp, is it plural? Results, yeah, there's an S there, as opposed to just result there where there's no S. So the result JSP, it's gonna have, well, in this case, I'll just have the regular struts tag up there. You know, it's a good idea always to have that page directive too. So I didn't have that on the original JSP, but you know, I'm gonna throw it in there just because that is convention, just a good idea to have. And now I don't need a full HTML page here. I just need a little bit of HTML because when you're working with Ajax, you only send back snippets of code. So I'm gonna say hello, and I'm gonna print out the value of the handle using a struts tag. And remember, handle is this property here that's got initialized, and it's initialized based on this value at Cameron MCNZ, which is a parameter to the link, which is invoked asynchronously. So I'll click Control S and save there. What am I getting barked at? The tag handler class for was not found on the Java build path. Well, I'm pretty sure that it was, so I'm not gonna worry too much about that. And now I'm gonna make sure everything's saved. I'm going to do a Maven update project, which is always a good idea. If you've played around with your POM file, then maybe even do a Maven clean. And then who knows, even a run as Maven install just to generate everything. I know I'm being a little bit paranoid here, but I just like to make sure everything is working. And now the last thing to do is just run this on the server. So I'm going to run this on my Tomcat server. And as this runs on the server, you'll see this say hello to at Cameron MCNZ. That's the link that I created. That's the spot where the Ajax result will go. When it comes in, I'll click on the link and notice it now says hello at Cameron MCNZ, but it's actually the same file that I started on. It didn't actually forward to the results JSP file there. And that's just evidence of the fact that we now have a struts based Ajax request response cycle using the struts jQuery plugin. And there you go, that's everything you need to know about Struts, Ajax, and jQuery. Now, if you wanna find out more about enterprise software development, head over to theserverside.com. I'm the editor-in-chief over there, and we've got lots of great tutorials and articles on Struts, Spring, Hibernate, anything to do with enterprise software development. If you're interested in my personal antics, you can follow me on Twitter, @CameronMCNZ, and subscribe on YouTube.